Please don't get...
Good evening. Hello, guys. Hi. I'm trying to be closer to my... Oh, sorry. Yeah, but I dropped it. Sorry. I'm so happy. I'm so happy that you two have the emote that I drew for Nishi. I'm really happy to see that he did get some subs on his birthday. And it is Nishi's birthday still, so If you haven't given Nishi your best wishes yet, I think it is a good idea to go to my Discord or to message Nishi on Twitter, to send him an email on Twitter, not email, message, sorry, to send him a message and simply wish him all the best there is in the world. I'm trying to find my microphone, but oh, here it is, okay. Come to mama, come to mama, come to mama microphone. Yeah, I rarely use it outside of my collabs, so hi Senmi. Oh, Dark Raven, hi, nice to see you. Good evening, hi. How's everyone's favorite radioactive scientist doing? I'm not sure how Comrade Dell is doing, but I'm sure he's pretty fine. But yeah, I'm really, really happy to see you guys today. I'm not sure how the weather is at your place, but here it's been raining cats and dogs, and it's been storming. So if you guys hear any noise from the weather, it's from the outside. It's not me. That was kind of kinky. What was kinky? I'm trying to spread my say-so energy here. Now somebody will probably say something, that the only thing getting spread here is the legs, not the say-so energy. But maybe you should just bonk yourselves, you know? Really, Shima? Right, as I'm taking a bath. Oh my gosh, Blended is so blessed with his bathtub. When you live in Poland, oh, thank you for the follow, Kabuzia. Thank you for the follow. When you live in Poland, the problem is that our bathrooms in the flat are very, very tiny. They don't even have windows most of the time, and they are usually cramped with all the things you need at home. So you have your washing machine there, and you have your sink, your toilet, and it usually has showers. A bathtub is a luxury in a block of flats. Say so, more like bottom left. Why is it the bottom left energy? I mean, I cannot deny the fact that I am a bottom. But I actually think it depends on the person. If when I was in a relationship with girls, because I actually do have more experience with women than I have with men. Fun fact about me, for the last day of the Pride Month, I did date more girls than I dated guys. So I think that when I was with a girl, I would take on more dominant role, and like with a guy, I think it's better to take a step back. But honestly, it just depends on the person, really. That's a very, very, very individual matter. Now you will probably want more king stories. But all in all, Twitch is more for adults, but I didn't tick that thingy that said she might doing more girls than most of teenagers. Well, like, first of all, I'm rather old, much older than teenagers. I mean, I am at this weird age when some of the people my age have companies, have families, have multiple kids, while others still live with their parents, and both of these situations are socially acceptable. So that's mid to late 20s for you, you know. Yeah, we do. Like, honestly, I haven't dated much for the past 10 years. But when I did date, I did tend to lean more towards females. So I'm kind of shocked that I did end up in a how do they say it? Is it a heteronormative relationship? Yeah, something like that. I'm kind of shocked. I'm kind of shocked because I would never see it for myself, and yet it worked. It works. So around 30, got it. Yeah. I think that Nishi and I we are the same age. Because I think it's public knowledge that I was born in 1993, so it makes me, biologically at least, that makes me 27 years old. When Taika was writing my wiki note, I told her that I'm 30 because I was too lazy to do this subtraction and to figure out how old I am. And the only reason I know how old I am is because I went to see the doctor recently, and when the doctor gives you the note, your age is printed out on it. So it said Fukushima Momochi, age 27, and I was like, oh. Oh, 27, that's how old I am. It's not really that old, is it? It really depends on whom you ask, because as I said many, many times, people on Stan Twitter, they tend to think that you die after you turn 25, which isn't that far from the truth, because my back tends to hurt like a little bitch. But I honestly blame myself for working long hours at the desk and then resting while streaming at my desk. So the sedentary lifestyle is the problem, because for me it's 100% or nothing. I either work really, really hard in the garden, or taking care of my family. I either work really hard to the point where I'm sweating and my heart is beating really fast, or I'm just sitting on the couch or in my armchair like a lazy potato. Well, it is said that love is blind. Oh yeah, love is blindness. I don't wanna see. That's a Jack White song. That's a Jack White song. Well, if it's true, then I'm living dead for some time now. Well, it's because I think that the problem is that young people, they tend to have a different idea of what being an adult is. Because let's be honest, most people don't start living on their own nowadays until they are like 30, 35. And when you even think about your parents, because I assume everybody here is a 90s kid. So in the 90s, it was actually a standard for people to marry quite young, and they would buy houses and stuff like that, because the market worked really, 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 really differently back then. And nowadays, the prices of flats or renting stuff, even, they are so high that many people cannot even afford to live on their own, yet alone to start a family. Speed running my bath. Use pressure washer. Oh yeah, that would wash his bones clean of flesh, you know. Ay. I was born mid-90s, so I'm not sure if that makes me 90s kid or not. Well, Dark Raven, it actually depends, because when you were born in the 90s in Poland, you got the true 90s kid experience, because everybody was really, really poor, and the technology was rather behind. I remember that we were playing on pirated Sega games and pirated Nintendo games. Super Mario, for example, ported, stuff like that. All the games from the 80s, they were rather popular in Poland in the 90s, because the technology got cheaper, you know? My message got blocked. Oh no. I don't know how Twitch works, because on YouTube, you can actually add people that you trust to your trusted user list. And then the messages, they don't get redacted. Maybe it's my fault. Does Twitch have like a live chat? No, it doesn't. It doesn't have a live chat and then a top chat like YouTube has. Okay, so dead ass. No idea how it works. Back in my home, I still have so many pirated movies from back in the day. Oh, like I actually have a ton of CDs I bought in middle school and high school. And now I don't have any equipment I could use to play them, so they just kind of sit in a box. I do have some vinyl records too, but it is much easier to find a record player like that in the attic than it is to find working CD player nowadays. Oh, you still have the Pegasus, the NES bootleg console. I think I've seen them on the Polish eBay for like 10 or 15 bucks. But the problem is that it said in the auction description that they cannot guarantee that it won't set your house on fire. I had like a closet full of pirated VHS movies that Russians sold me. Oh, honest to God, I remember I got a copy of Lord of the Rings with Russian voiceover, and I was so pissed because even as a kid I had a pretty good understanding of English, and I was so pissed because it was so hard for me to understand the voiceover. But then the actors in Lord of the Rings, they delivered the lines so clearly that it was rather easy for me to understand it, even as a kid, you know? I had a friend of my father has been doing copies, and I have some copies with my mail on disc Jesus Christ, Jester, I cannot read that. Yeah, but you butchered it hardcore. I have no idea what you meant. What did you mean? What did you mean, the baby boy? Please, please, please retype it. But yeah, there is this assumption that being a VTuber is only for young people, mostly because Hololive and Nijisanji, they tend to higher talents, which would be the same age that an idol company would hire. Well, with the exception of the English branch, of course, but the corporate VTubers, they tend to be pretty young. Even though on the English VTuber scene, I've seen a bunch of people who started VTubing in their 40s or 50s even. So in the end of the day, when it comes to technology, when it comes to entertainment, age is just a number. And especially in VTubing, your personality is what shines the most. So I wouldn't act in an ageist way and ban old people like Shima or older from being a VTuber, you know. Let's just pretend I didn't send anything. Okay, let's pretend that. No worries, Jester. Okay. So I am actually so tired today, and I can mod my own chat. Okay, so that message was suka bliat rushbi. Suka bliat rushbi. Don't say we're old, because I feel old as well. Oh, send me. We are actually, if you compare the life of a 27-year-old to a 17-year-old, for example, you have so much more freedom, because firstly, you have your own money. You don't have anybody telling you what to do with it. You don't have anybody giving you curfews and stuff like that. Shima is old. How dare she? Instaban from VTubing for life. Well, mentally, I feel like I'm 10,000 years old. Like honestly, if I died, I wouldn't regret that I had a short life, because I dead ass think that I've had enough for one person. But the only concern of mine would be that my family is without the caregiver, so that would be sad. That would be pretty sad. This is the best part of being adult and single. You are basically a teenager with money. Oh yeah. You have a ton of freedom like that. When you are a caregiver, oh my gosh, it's raining even harder. When you are a caregiver for a family, it's a bit different, because they are dependent on you, and at the same time you are kind of codependent on them, because you know, when you have people physically and emotionally dependent on your care, you tend to take your strength and your motivation from them, you know. So definitely being in a family, being a caregiver is a very, very codependent relationship. But as a single and ready to mingle man in your early 20s, you have a ton of freedoms. So I kind of envy that, but at the same time, I wouldn't trade the life that I'm living for anything. Thank you for the follow. On one hand, I feel like a teenager, but on the other, I feel like the teen I used to be is literally dead. Oh, thank you for the follow. Indian port, Poirot. sorry if I butchered it. Well, like honestly, oh my gosh, what is this flood of follows? Thanks for the follows, guys. On one hand, oh my gosh, you redeemed the drone nudes. Oh my gosh, oh my gosh, you did redeem draw nudes. Okay. Sile, please let me know in the Discord what kind of nudes do you want me to draw, and I will draw it. Okay. I will draw the nudes. And jokes on you guys, because there is a limit on the nudes. There is a limit on how many nudes you can redeem. There is one redeem per week limit, because I have my job, my day job, I have my caregiver work. Also, I have a ton of videos to edit, and all that work is just piling up on me, you know? Just don't send your own. Well, actually, please don't ban me Twitch for saying that, but when I draw nudes, I mean, I tend to keep them in my drawer. I rarely post them. I think I've only posted one, but when I draw them, I tend to take inspiration from life, and the easiest accessible female is me myself. So I find it that sitting naked in front of the mirror is the easiest way to figure out how to draw nudes. Then again, when you're trying to do a stylized piece, especially if you are going after a Japanese animation style, I think it's better to use stylized references, you know, because the titty physics in adult animation and the ones we have in real life, they are a bit different now, aren't they? That's why Melody is so successful. I think I read it in one of her interviews that the real life physics is so boring, especially the one that limits our body. That's why she felt so inspired to become a virtual cam girl, and I honestly couldn't agree more with her. That was a lovely idea. Lucky for me, I don't have enough points yet, but I'm close. Yeah, I think that for a non-sub, it's 20 hours of watching or something. So, if you take into the consideration that I'm streaming in English more or less every other day, it's like 2 weeks of watching. I don't have any idea. Could Twitch chat help in choosing the subject of ludies? Just please, for the love of God, pick a female, because I'm not very good at drawing boys. So I'm wondering if I should just go with chatting, or maybe check out the writing. You need a model. I guess yourself is a no-no. I mean, if you want me to do myself, I can do myself. No problem then. I would just step my foot in if the person was to say so in my eyes. Let's say if somebody wanted nudes of Taika, I would be like, nah, I don't think she would be comfortable with that. Nah. But if it's an old degenerate like me, then go ahead. If you need boys reference, maybe ask your significant other. Well, the problem is that the type of guy I want to draw would be like more on the lanky and feminine side, and my SO is like 6 feet tall, bare titties, huge beard, huge guy, a ton of muscles. So all in all, I'm pretty surprised that I ended up with somebody like that, since I was pretty gay my whole life and uninterested in men most of the time. But it is what it is, right? I can do myself, Shima 2021. Oh my gosh. I only have my own titties and Bara titties at home, so maybe I would have to go through those pages with references. Draw ponies, Nishi will be happy. Well, on one hand, Nishi is very, very proud. Nishi is very, very proud of his time in the pony fandom. But on the other, these doors are shut. That's just something that I guess we can tease him about in chat. But he's moved on. He's moved on from that. Oh, thanks for the posture check. Thank you so much. I'm gonna do a posture check because I feel my back is creaking. Okay, so I'm gonna do my eye rest as I stretch. Okay, no problem there. Okay, and at the same time, I'm gonna hydrate. Yeah, I got this. Okay, that was dumb. That was rather dumb. Oh my gosh. Did I set the limit for the stretch? Or am I just gonna have to stretch this entire stream? Okay, I feel like I was born again, really. Thank you for all the redeems, guys. I think you did get rid of all your points. Jesus Christ. I don't want to use an ad block because I'm not a leech, right? But Jesus Christ. More stretch. More. Jump. Yeah. So maybe I should move on to reading those stories. As I was carted off to the cells for back-to-back life terms, I heard one of the jurors whisper the sentences. How horrifying. Okay, don't understand this one. I'm on one brain cell today, so we will just move on to the next one. My wedding dress was white and gold, but the skin under it was black and blue. I came here for horror and not for pity. Like this is just sad because you know there are so many people which are trapped or forced into marriages. Like in the States, it's legal to marry off a child with the consent of the parents. So that's horrifying. Yeah. I wanted something spooky and lighthearted, and this like kind of hard, right in the feels, bro. My blind date texted that he'd finally arrived and was sorry for being 15 minutes late to pick me up, but we'd been already driving for 10. Oh my gosh. Stranger danger. Well, it is horror, psychological one. There's nothing better than the sound of child's laugh until it's 3 a.m. and you live alone. Best one, the most terrifying. I think the one with the, like, that's one that's really, really horrifying. And then there are the ones which hurt you right in the feels, like the one that read for sale newborn's shoes never worn or something like that, you know, something that would imply a loss of a child, you know. So what I'm trying to say is, if these horrors, if they are about something that's abstract and unreal, then yeah, these are all shits and fun and giggles. But if they touch on our deepest, darkest fears, then it's no bueno. No bueno. I could barely hide my excitement when the doctor told me my child had cancer. This would definitely spice up my mommy blog. Oh my gosh, you fucking bitch. It's so sad because it's absolutely true. It's absolutely true. Those mommy bloggers, firstly, they make a career of monetizing their child, and they always need to make sure that their children are a subject worth describing. The problem is that they monetize their private life, and I see it a lot, especially on Facebook. They tend to create those closed off groups, and they really, really leech off of the loneliness of motherhood, and they try to create a place that seems inclusive, but in all actuality, it's just a market for the influencer to sell the stuff that they get commission for, or to use those faithful supporters as an army in case of any criticism from the outside world, let's say, from the people which are not mommy bloggers, basically. So it's really, really sad because those people are very, very lonely, and they feel like they found a friend, like they found a friend on the other side of the screen. But in the end of the day, they are just a money-making machine. Social media should be accessible only after a doctor check. Well, I think that I honestly think that a family vlogging shouldn't be allowed, because there are mommy bloggers which document the entire lives of the children from the very beginning, from the pregnancy even. And I've seen a post from one guy on Reddit, and his mother was a very, very influential mommy blogger. He had a bunch of siblings, like 7 of them, and he was bullied hardcore because there was everything on him online. And he ended up ordering a hoodie and a t-shirt that read, "Don't photograph me. I do not wish to be in this photograph. Don't post this online. I do not consent to being on your blog." Just stuff like that. And she would still continue to put up content with him and about him, because that was what got her clicks. So the lack of empathy and seeing your children as money-making machines is really, really disgusting. It's absolutely disgusting. And I don't think it should be allowed. Because kids should be kids. Like, they shouldn't be working. And the difference between child actors and family vloggers is that child actors are under the laws that won't allow them to work more than 4 or 5 hours a day, something like that. And family vloggers, they are on the clock all day long. So, did you hear that? That there's a fly. There's a fly on my microphone. Did you guys hear that? So yeah. If I had to host my own panel, what pisses me off, I would say mommy vloggers, definitely. Definitely. Nope. Oh, you didn't hear her. I definitely did hear her in my iPhone, in my headphone. Sorry. I just assumed that it was a she. Okay, the next one. Go away, you fly. I'm trying to stream. Just go. Just go. Go! Yeah. Okay, let's continue. Oh, not this one. Not that these are the buttons, but a bit. He gently pulled the blanket up to her chin, tucking her in tight, and whispered into her ear, "Your daughter is dead," chuckling to himself as he walked out of the room, closing the door on her feeble sobs. He rejoiced in the small pleasures afforded to him working in the Alzheimer's care home. Jesus Christ. First of all, this should be at least 4 sentences. And second of all, fuck. I really like the ones which are very, very subversive, you know? And this one was subversive. So yeah, I dig this one. This one is really good. But also, the guy is a dick. Guy is a dick, no denying that. Sorry, I spilled the water on myself. Jesus Christ. These are the buttons your war hero great granddaddy took from the people he killed, said Mom as she handed me the battered old tin box. I counted 5 old Wehrmacht buttons, 3 SS, 1 Luftwaffe, 3 FedEx, 2 Pizza Hut, and 6 USPS buttons. Oh my gosh. This one is great too. Like, if the story is subversive, then it's great. I would like to write nice. Because that's my type of horror, but more like joke this one. I mean, the guy did kill 6 postmen, so I'm rather impressed. Did they move a lot? Like, imagine if there was a spot open at your post office and the 6 previous mailmen disappeared mysteriously. Would you take up the job? I don't think so. I think that flipping burgers would be safer. Ay. Okay. Let me check the comments for this one. My best friend was on the radio today, and the dashboard, steering wheel, and window. Okay, it hit me. Okay, let me upvote it. Jesus Christ. 6, he didn't go far enough. well, like jokes aside, the problem with postmen is that they will always leave you a note that they tried to deliver something. And you weren't home, even though you were at home all day. So if those guys did something like that, they definitely deserve that. I think the police would be interested after just one. It really depends on what type of neighborhood you live in, really. Is this the right one? It doesn't hurt anymore, babe. My girlfriend murmurs sleepily as she snuggles closer. We've stopped shaking too, I mumble blearily as we huddle together in this frozen cabin, a distant voice in my head trying to remember why this seems like a bad thing. Oh, that's a really, really hard one. But I did read that out of all the deaths in the wilderness, drowning and freezing to death are by far the most pleasant ones, because your brain just slowly shuts off its functions, right? So it's not that bad. I mean, you die, so it is pretty fatal, but you don't suffer that much. You just slowly doze off, and you basically nod off to eternal slumber. Dude, wake up, it's 2006. Oh my gosh, I think I would still be in primary school. That would be actually kind of scary. Like imagine, I know that for some people it's a fantasy, like in that manga, The City Without Me, Kono Sekai ni, something like that. I don't know. sorry, I don't know Japanese. I think it's called The City Without Me. So the manga where the guy goes back in time and he tries to prevent the murders of his classmates, and then he succeeds and gets into a coma. So he kind of goes back to the place where he started because of that coma. On one hand, a scenario like that is a fantasy for many people, but I think it would be so terrifying to be an adult in the body of a child. It's called Erased in English. It's called Erased. It's simply called Erased in English. Jesus Christ. So it's called A City Without Me in Polish. But yeah, I'm glad that you figured out the title. That's a stupid name. It was on Netflix. Yeah, it was on Netflix. I did watch it. I did watch it on Netflix too, but I kind of liked the manga better. So all in all, it seems like such a nightmare scenario. Like I cannot even imagine. Maybe it's because I was bullied as a kid, and now I have a life that's way better than I did have as a kid. So having to go through stuff like that again would be just way too much for me. But then again, in that manga, the guy goes back with a superpower, more or less, because in the beginning, when he is delivering pizza, we learn that he has the sixth sense kind of thing. His spidey sense is tingling when shit's about to hit the fan, you know. So all in all, a good idea for a manga, not a nice scenario for real life people. Yeah. Oh my gosh, it's already midnight. It is kind of late now, isn't it? As I hear little boy suffocating in his sleep, I wish I could turn him over so he can breathe again. After all, everybody knows that monsters can touch you when you're under a blanket. Oh my gosh. This one is subversive too, and it understands the rules of our world perfectly. I was bullied through primary. I found few friends, and I still keep contact with them, even though slim. Oh, I'm so happy for you. I'm genuinely happy for you that things got better in middle. For me, it was very bad in primary. It was even worse in middle. It was so bad. It was so bad that I had to go like halfway through middle school. I had to switch. I had to go to a different school. And when I was like after I graduated high school, one of my middle school bullies told me that she was so hard on me because she was jealous that I was pretty and smart. And I was like, bruh. And at the same time, I was like, oh my gosh, what a character progression. How much you grew as a person. I was dead ass impressed by her. But still, that was this one girl. And I think I've had like 20 bullies, you know? Sponsors, the real horror on this site. Who is the sponsor? Get the best sponsors for your stream. Oh, maybe you guys could be my sponsors. How about that? Well, I remember I pushed on of bullies into walls so hard he lost consciousness. No regrets. Oh my gosh. You know, the problem with girls is that, you know, when you are bullied by girls, is that women, they are like, especially teenage girls, they are way more vicious than teenage boys, I feel. I mean, like whenever guys argue, if things end up in a fight, they usually hit each other once, and then they are more or less even. And women, they will pick on you until you end yourself, and that's a sad truth. So luckily for me, my family started doing a bit better financially, so I was able to transfer to a better school in a bigger city. And on one hand, I was given a chance to rewrite myself, to start fresh, but on the other, I was so tired and so afraid of people at that point that I would just hikikomoru in my dorm room, play games, read mangas, watch anime. I would even skip classes because sometimes I didn't feel like being too social. But I did graduate middle school and high school with pretty decent grades, probably because I was pretty. I would call it book smart, because there is book smart and there is street smart, and I have zero street smartness, you know. What, my internet died. What are we on about? High school bullies. Sadly, my emotions dulled over time, maybe too much, I think sometimes. Yeah, I think that, when you are bullied and when you hurt so much, you tend to push those negative feelings deep into you, and that's one of the things that I do to this day. I will usually push all those negative emotions deep inside of me, to the point where I cannot take it anymore, and I snap. And then I lose all my motivation and all my strength. But I tend to get back up on my feet pretty easily, especially now when I have a family to care for. I have this channel, this really small community that is always out there for me. So you guys are one of the things that keeps me going. So thank you so much for being here. You truly are a blessing. Oh, I think I never heard one. Oh my gosh, what a blessing. What a blessing. I got nothing on this. My school life was annoying in middle school, but that's about it. Yeah, because I think that when you stand out too much from the crowd, they get this instinct to kind of beat you into submission. I don't know how it works, but it works like that. All I can say about life in any level of school, kids are savages with no rules whatsoever. Oh yeah, I think that's true. I think that's true. And the problem is that our educators are underpaid, so they cannot be bothered. They can't be bothered with it. So yeah, maybe we should read another story and it will redirect the conversation onto something more positive. Or if not positive, then maybe something more abstract. Is it okay in a minute? Press X to doubt. Contrary to a popular belief, vampires don't burn in the sunlight and are never seen during the day simply because they're nocturnal. You can still wait for the sunrise to come outside if it makes you feel safer. I don't really care if I have to stay up late. Oh, okay, okay, Edward. Okay. As a child, I always enjoyed putting two mirrors next to each other and seeing the endless mirror tunnel. Seeing the endless mirror tunnel that would form. I stopped doing it when I saw the thing climbing through the mirrors towards me. Oh, yabe. That one was meh. Yeah, because that's just the top from the week. I always told my daughter that our dog's fur was like a coat to keep him warm in the winter. Okay. Click to see NSFW. I would regret my choice of words as my bloody little girl came to tell me, scissors in hand, that it was so hot she had taken his coat off. Bruh. Infinite corridor. Well, like truth be told, infinite mirrors are a very, very popular thing in interior designs nowadays. And you can make it by using LED tape, and it looks kind of cool. Also, having mirrors, like if you have a narrow corridor in your home and you simply place mirrors on two sides of the wall, that really creates a cool effect. Like starting into the infinite recording of OBS. Two OBSs facing each other. and then a streamer comes out. Who's the most popular streamer on Twitch? I was concerned. Is it showing? Yeah, it's not showing. It's not showing. It's okay. I was concerned when my husband said that he was going to commit out our son to mental hospital. Too late. I realized that he said our son, not our son, as I watched the hospital burn to the ground. He was going to commit arson. Oh, that one is clever. Okay. Recruiting is fun. You don't say. When the officiator, shit, I don't know how to read this one, asked Marie if she would take me as her husband, she began to tear up. She and the entire wedding party began to howl with laughter as she said, "I'm sorry, this is the longest prank I've ever pulled, and I can't believe you fell for it." Jesus Christ, that is so cruel. That is so freaking cruel. Like, I remember when I was in high school, some girls would ask guys which were not very social, not very popular. Basically basement goblins like me, but male. They would ask them for dates, and they would stand them up. They would ghost them, basically. and they would laugh at them for being so gullible, is the word, for being so naive. And that was shitty. That was shitty. Like, how can you do that to a person? Everybody wants somebody. Like everybody who wants a relationship would fall for something like that. So that's just cruel. Less horror, more dad joke. Yeah, like when I was a kid, I was at the wedding where the guy said no at the altar. I think I've said this story a few times on the channel. But when I was younger, I did go with my mother to a wedding. I think we were on the bride's side, but I'm not sure. I think we were on the bride's side because her dad was paying for the reception and we stayed. So I think we were bride's family. But the guy dead ass said no at the altar when she was all dressed up, full face of makeup, hair done, veil, big ass gown and stuff. And that was so shitty. Like if you chicken out, you should say her before she gets all dressed up, before you humiliate her in front of your family and friends. Just my ugly face. Oh, back with the snack, and I think I saw a horrible thing in the mirror. Just my ugly face. Well, I think it was explained on Reddit, the Bloody Mary phenomenon, you know, where you just stand in front of the mirror in the dark and you say Bloody Mary, Bloody Mary, Bloody Mary, and something scary shows up in the mirror. It's because your brain is so bored of seeing your ugly ass face that it starts to make up images. So that's how it works. That's how it works. It's just our brain thinking we ugly and boring. Okay, I'm gonna stretch a little because my back is starting to hurt. The next one. My roommate hasn't left his room in 3 weeks. I know he's depressed, but he's gonna have to do something about that smell. Dude. Just connect the dots, okay? And she's going to haunt your boss and Jake. Yeah, like back in the day, in the early 2000s, I think, like 2010s, that's when those creepy stories, creepypastas, like Slendermans, Jeff the Killer, stuff like that was really, really popular. I remember people would write spoof stories of of those popular creepypastas, and Dad has no idea how to pronounce them in English. Yeah, it would sometimes end like that. Or, you know, like one guy calls onto the Bloody Mary, ask her if she would go on a date with him, and she says, "Nah, mate, I'm good." Późno. Yeah, it is. I'm sorry, guys. I know it is rather late, and even though I'm trying to target the English-speaking audience, most of my viewers are Polish, so I do feel kind of dumb. Speaking English to a bunch of Polish audience. I think that still on this Twitch, like 40% of my viewers are from Poland. And on my YouTube, I have like 50% Poles, 40% Russians, and 10% random people who find my tutorials. I was referring to the troll pasta. Oh yeah, sorry. I feel even dumber. To the horror of everyone watching from Earth, the first man on Mars took off his helmet. He was finally home. Okay, cool. But if there was a race of sentient aliens on Mars, which would be able to infiltrate our society, then I think it would be the safest for them to just eliminate all life on Earth. Because you know how humans are. Like, don't tell me we wouldn't enslave a sentient race of aliens if we found them in space. We would totally enslave them, nuke them, use their resources against them, because that's how humanity works. We are on top of the chain because we are greedy, greedy and shitty, you know? You could set Twitch panel for location of current viewers. Yeah, is there a panel for that? Because I know in the analytics I can see how many viewers from where I get and which viewers share which I mean which creators share viewer base with me so that I can ask for collab or something. But yeah, you know, I'm streaming really late at night. So maybe, just maybe, some stray American viewers could come pop up in my chat and make me the most popular Central European streamer. No, that spot's taken. That's the Kanashinkiara for you. Dude, we have done all that and more to ourselves. What we would do to something truly other would be horrifying. Oh yeah, and like especially because if you have people advocating for animal rights, for example, but you have the ma vast majority of population not giving two shits about the well-being of animals, right? So if there was a sentient species of aliens that we would enslave, I'm sure the media and the governments would push a narrative that they are lesser than us and it is completely ethical for humanity to take advantage of them, you know? It's called Viewer Geolocation Panel, you should check it out. Oh, okay, you know what? Let me take a note. Where is my note? Oh, I'm gonna stretch my back. Is this an invoice for a customer? Yeah, it is. Okay. Viewer geolocation panel. Okay. I have to be real with you folks. It's getting difficult for me to keep my spirits up on this stream because this is just depressing. Sorry guys, I will have to excuse myself from this stream. Good night. Oh yeah, I'm really sorry. I'm sorry. I didn't want the subjects to turn this dark. Maybe next time when I'm tired, I will either pick more lightweight subreddit, or I will simply do a just chatting stream. I think it's also hard for you because it's 1:30, so you must be tired from your day activities. So no hard feelings. If you want to go to sleep, just go ahead and go to sleep. Oh. Not this one, this one. Did you know that some predators hunt using the ability to detect movements from the prey? Now you might begin to understand why your sleep paralysis demons can't hurt you. Well, that's just dumb. That's just dumb. That is just dumb and makes zero sense because if they cannot hurt me when I am paralyzed, why would they, be sleep paralysis demons, why wouldn't they switch their occupation to demons that bully joggers in the park or something? That's just dumb. Unless that paralysis is a defense mechanism, but then it's just done. Can't relate, never had sleep paralysis. Oh yeah, I do have sleep paralysis. actually. But it never lasts long for me. It's usually just a couple of seconds. So before I understand fully that this is the sleep paralysis phenomenon, I just got a full control over my body. I like the one about not being able to sleep because sleep server are full, so you need to wait for a slot. There was this one story that when you cannot fall asleep, it is because you are awake in somebody else's dream. And that's dumb. That's dumb because our brains, when we are dreaming, they tend to place re I mean they don't tend, they do place real life people in our dreams because a human face is something that our brain cannot make up, you know? So they actually use real life people as NPCs in our dreams. I think that is kind of cool, you know? Okay, next one. The bartender had gotten my name wrong. My name is Henry, but she put help me instead. What a bad restaurant. The bartender? Maybe the barista at Starbucks. Or maybe she wrote him a check. Jesus Christ. I don't know. This is too American for me. I mean, in Poland, they only scribble on your Starbucks. Yeah, 2 out of 10. Yeah, not really good. Not very good. Jesus Christ, that's a big verb. I've never seen it in writing before. Elevate all homeless problem. The philanthropist donated a new tent, sleeping bag, and solar powered lantern to every unhoused person in the US. The tents and bags were constructed of polyurethane polymer not to reduce cost, but because of the materials. Oh my gosh, who wrote this? Why did you use such big words? The sense, like the essence of this one is that somebody gave homeless people flammable materials so that they set themselves on fire. But the way this is worded is just like wah. Just a pain to read. Just a pain to re pain to read. Just because you have vast and good command of the English language, and just because you can use all those big fancy big boy words doesn't mean you have to use them to be a good writer, you know? I'm trapped in the fortune cookie factory joke. Well, maybe it's just a knockoff of that story, that lady of the lady who called 911 and faked to order a pizza, you know? The more you read, the more I think I'm desensitized. r/ I am very smart writing style in the last one. Yeah, definitely. Because as I said, just because you know all that fancy vocabulary doesn't mean you have to use it. It's actually better to use simpler wording when you want to write something that reads easily. And this is a 2-sentence subreddit for ghost for Christ's sake. And those sentences, they were so long to just like, bruh, 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 bruh. Shaking my head. I saw on the news that her husband reported her missing 4 days ago. I r rescued her at least 7 days ago. Clearly, he doesn't love her the same as I do. Oh, ouch, 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 ouch. Oh, hi, Mavzo. Hi, good evening. After I killed my wife's doppelganger, the real Amy smiled. Then she took my wife's diary from behind her back and said, "It's a good thing I had the answers to all your questions." Okay, that's a bit cryptic. That's a bit cryptic, but really good one. Really good one, actually. Now, question: love affair or kidnapping? Well, this could be a kidnapper too, because they actually tend to fall in love with the kidnappees. Kidnappees? Is that how you say it? The person who was kidnapped, right? They tend to form this pathological relationship. So maybe the OP by rescuing, maybe they did mean that they set her free. But then the husband ended her. Yeah, you know, when it leaves a ton of room for speculation, it's a good one. If it's like, oh, we made it out of high-tech shit that you don't know about because you didn't go to a fancy college, it's just let us get our free Reddit entertainment when we are on the toilet, bruh. Thumbs up. This one's kind of shitty. Is it showing? After my sister committed suicide, I discovered her self-portrait and a note saying it represents her in the afterlife. Ever since it turned into a blank canvas, I pray to God every night she will leave my family alone. Oh, see? See? That's a good one. That's a good one. Because it is nothing that touches our deep, dark personal fears. It's just a bunch of bull, basically. That's a good one. Yeah. I'd give anything just to live for another month, she desperately pleaded with the Grim Reaper. The hooded figure nodded, lowering the blade of its scythe to her 8-month pregnant belly. Oh. That's a painful one. Okay, that's a really painful one. There is this subreddit called r/make me suffer, and like those posts that people post over there, they really do make you suffer. And this one, yeah, that one was good. Yeah, it was really good, cause like, in the end of the day, like if a story is about a deal with a higher entity, like a demon or something, it should always be something that will screw you up no matter what you do. Like a really good story about a deal with the devil is the oh my gosh, is the expansion to The Witcher 3 with the Gunther Odin guy. Because it screwed the guy over big time. So that's who pings me. Who had the audacity to ping me? Please don't ping me when I'm streaming, okay? Thank you. But yeah, all in all, this one was really good. This one was really good. My heart was racing as I pulled the slimy blue worms from my hands and neck. The red ones had burrowed deep inside, and if it wasn't for this LSD, I wouldn't have thought to fish them out with pliers. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. Oh yeah, bear. I have Audacity. You have Audacity on your PC. On your PC installed for the terrible audio editing experience with Audacity. As I read his two-sentence horror stories, I noticed the common theme about a female character getting tortured by various methods. His most recent one was last night, said the detective, who showed them to me. So there's a chance your daughter is still alive. Oh my gosh, it's still alive. Oh my god. Oh my gosh. I actually just watched the movie with Morgan Freeman about that kidnapping of the four-year-old child. So the kidnapping is really, really scary, especially when it comes to children, because you know, usually if the person is not found within 24 hours, then their fate is sealed. Because it is very, very hard to hide or to be on the run with a minor. It is so painful. Jesus Christ. I should have not chosen this subreddit. I should have not chosen this one. I think I will, if I want to do a reading or chatting stream, I will just choose something like r/choosingbeggars or something, or maybe delusional artists, because when you are angry at someone, it is rather cathartic, you know, when you can be angry at something that you have no control over, and these horror stories, they tend to hit you right in the feels. So it is quite difficult. Maybe I recommend r/iBleach, safe for work. Oh, okay, we can go to iBleach then. iBleach. Dim. Let's join this one, because Black Lives Matter, yeah, they do. How to teach your dog to drive. Okay, let's take the top of all time. Okay. An elephant playfully stealing and then returning a hat. Oh, that is so wholesome. That is actually pretty wholesome. Oh my gosh, the young George Floyd. Okay. Let's move to the another post. Oh, there's a doggy getting a pig's ear. I'm gonna move this window so you guys can see. Where is this? Oh. Wasn't locked. Okay. Doggo. Oh, why are his ears so pointy? Did they trim them? Because in Poland, because in the European Union, it is actually banned to trim the ears on the dog. But this guy is so cute. So cute. I think that I safely assume that this is a pit bull, right? I think that they look more dangerous with the ears clipped, and since it is banned in the union, they tend to look so clumsy and so cute. If I've ever gotten a dog, I would like a pit bull. Because they seem to be so sweet. I'm watching 101 Dalmatians at the bar. Oh, doggies. Okay. A pooch on top of the pooch. Oh my gosh, is this subreddit just filled with dogs? Cute. Okay, this is actually a pretty wholesome sub. A comfort dog that helps sick dog's patients know that everything will be alright. Oh, I love this sub. I feel like this is the purification that we needed. Also, I think it is pretty telling that this sub has mostly pets. Take your finger, my dear friend. Oh my, so sweet. Oh my gosh, that is so cute. I love that one too, yeah. Hence the name, I Bleed. Yeah, I thought this was actually going to be something that will make us want to bleach our eyes out, but actually no, this is for the purification of our souls after this horrible sub. So I think this is actually quite nice that we are moving on to the more wholesome sub. Big woof woof woof. Yeah, this doggo is pretty big. Maybe it's a half wolf, half doggo. Oh, gray wolf transforms into a good boy. There was this experiment, I think. I watched it on National Geographic or something. And there was a bunch of vet students who were given wolf puppies to raise to see if they will be able to tame them and if they will be able to treat them like dogs, basically. And the problem was that even like at a very, very young age, they would become very, very disruptive, and they would just keep to their own pack. So they were placed in a sanctuary in the end of the experiment, and it was a fail. So it's actually kind of nice to see somebody just playing with a wolf. Also, it is so big. It is so freaking big. Like, wow. Wow. You can ride it to a battle. Oh. Oh, he wants to give you kisses. Oh my gosh, that's so cute. Oh, that's just the sweetest. Home run! Oh. Oh yeah, that's very, very sweet too. Oh. Oh my gosh, a corgi! Oh, I love that he timed out himself. That's really, really cute. Now go get the ball, son. Like I, cause we do not play baseball at school in Poland. Cause I don't know why. Maybe it's because Polish people tend to prefer baseball bats over any other equipment for baseball. But I digress. On baseball fields, they tend to have really, really, really high nets, so that the ball. Oh my gosh, what's the verb? It ricochet, you know? My German Shepherd was having a false pregnancy, so I got her German Shepherd, Alaskan Husky puppy. She thinks it's hers and the pup thinks it's her mom, and I'm never going to tell them different. Oh, that is so cute. That is so cute. Oh my gosh. Bounce back. Yeah. Bounce back, that was the word. Sorry, I'm actually starting to get kind of tired. So maybe we will just scroll through the sub a bit more, and then I will go to bed, cuz I did start a tiny bit too late, a bit later than I would prefer. If I start at 10:30, then I will stream for 2 hours. And I think that I started like past 11 p.m. So that was kind of late. I'm really, really hopeful that I will resolve my family issues. I will be more free to stream more. I will definitely have time to stream during the day, British summer time or CET time. So we will see. We will see how the platform grows, if it will grow. Oh, sorry, I have hiccups. Sorry, guys. I'm sorry. I've been splashing the water. We upgraded our lab equipment. Bunsen now has a little system named Beaker. Oh, that is so cute. Oh my gosh. Also, I envy people who can afford two dogs or two pets, really. Even though I know that it's ideal to have two dogs or two cats, because they have each other's company when you are at work or when you are busy, so that's perfect. But the cost of keeping two pets, of two visits at the vets, of twice the amount of food, it's just pretty overwhelming, pretty overbearing. But in the end of the day, it is more beneficial for dogs to be adopted in pairs. Yeah. Good boy trying his hardest to pose with food at the ballpark. Oh, that's so sweet. It's so sweet. And I wonder if these are the team colors or maybe they just match because they are best buddies. Oh yeah, that's really, really fun and cute and sweet. I love it. Okay, well, the video with the kitty, and then I finish the stream for now. I love that the guy is having the same reaction as me. Because like, that's so lovely. Okay, guys, you know what? I think we will actually turn this off. We will actually turn this off. And yeah, who is streaming? Yeah, Project Melody is streaming, but I'm not gonna raid Melody because she probably has her raids limited to her friends, only, which is fair. When you are a big streamer, you want to prevent being raided by bots and stuff. So maybe I could raid Komi again, because I see that Komi is streaming and I know that Komi is okay. It's okay with me raiding her. So maybe we will raid Komi. I think it's good. Eyes bleached after horrible serve, not go to sleep. Yeah, I think we need to, I think I need to plan my chatting streams better. The problem is that I was running rather late and I didn't want to stream gaming, because even when I'm well rested, I'm bad at playing games, and when I'm tired, I'm very, 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 very bad at them, you know. So yeah, maybe I will locate a better sub to use as a crutch for streaming, chatting streams. But in the end of the day, I think that you guys make me so talkative that I don't need anything to go through when I'm streaming with you guys. So yeah, let's just rate Komi for now. Rate channel. Okay, we're gonna rate Komi now. Okay, who's ready for a ride? I never know if it's a raid or if it's a ride, but yeah, let's start it now in 3 2, 1. Thank you for watching. Please don't forget to join my Discord, follow, go to my YouTube, like my videos and subscribe and all that. Yada, 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 yada. Okay, okay. Let's rate her now.
How cute. Aura, aura.
Leave me alone.